Two Australians on the pool deck now in the men's 100 butterfly. The final, and they're through as the two fastest qualifiers. It's been a remarkable rivalry, Geoff Huegill and Michael Klim. 4 and 5 tonight. Can the Australians go 1-2? And who will be one?
Well, the Australians have never won a gold medal in this event. We won silver in 1996 and bronze in 1984. Can we go 1-2? Or there's also the possibility that someone may upset. We've seen it happen before and come through for the gold. But I think Geoff Huegill and Michael Klim certainly looked fantastic in the semi-finals.
Lane one, Thomas Ruppreth from Germany. Looked very good in the relay this morning. Was powerful.
Second at the European Championships, qualified in 53.18.
Lane two from Canada, Michael Nintenko.
Sixth at the Pan Pacs in 99, qualified in 53 flat.
Lane three, representing the USA, Ian Crocker, looked strong in his semi-final last night. Much improved performance on his heat.
And for relaxation, he plays guitar in a jazz ensemble. Personal best of 52.78, qualified in 52.82.
Lane four, fastest qualifier. Geoff Huegill.
First at the Commonwealth Games in 98, qualified in an Olympic record of 51.96.
Mixed emotions for the crowd, two of their favourites against each other. The world record holder, Michael Klim, in lane number five.
Qualified in 52.63, world record holder at 51.81.
Lane six, the European champion, Lars Frölander.
First at the European Championships, qualified in 52.84. This could be one of the danger men.
The Swede. Lane seven, Tahashi Yamamoto from Japan.
Third at the Pan Pacs in 99, qualified in 53.01.
Oh, hey, in your face. Lane eight. Anatoly Polyakov, the Russian.
Qualified in 53.32, just outside his personal best.
A great opportunity for Australia here. Huegill in four, Klim in five. An air of expectation. Huegill standing back slightly.
Klim and Huegill both sensational races in high pressure events. Watch for Klim's fast start.
They're set and away. Huegill drops slightly, the fastest qualifier in 51.96. Alongside him, the world record holder, the world champion. Going quickly, Crocker up and stroking in first place. Working through now is Huegill. Klim is right with him. They're shoulder to shoulder. Frölander off the speed. Crocker going quickly in lane to Mintenko. He's working down towards the wall as well. Huegill and Klim. Klim may be marginally in front. Around they go.
Well, Klim and Huegill, they've gone in together. It's going to see who's done the most training and who's got the best finishing ability.
Great turn by Michael Klim. Suddenly, he's a metre in front. Huegill can't go with him. Michael Klim is out. Frölander is coming on. Klim and Frölander. Frölander in lane six. Now Huegill finishing strongly. Klim still in front. Frölander the danger. Klim weakening. Frölander coming over the top. Frölander in lane six. May tip them out. Frölander goes in. Frölander's won. Australia second and third. Klim is second. Huegill is third. Frölander in lane six. The Swede, the European champion, has crashed down the outside in the butterfly final and upset the Australians tonight. What a wonderful swim.
Well, I picked him here and he swam a personal best in his 100 freestyle and he looked dangerous coming into this meet. He was just outside Geoff Huegill and Michael Klim's personal best and he certainly knows how to race. Klim and Huegill have done a sensational job. Klim in second, Huegill in third. And what a fast Olympic final. Michael Klim got a fantastic start. He really works his starts and his turns, and he's probably the best turner in the world. And I just think that Huegill was labouring a little bit in the first 50, probably didn't get the best of starts. And it's a high-pressure meet, a high-pressure race. And both Australians didn't get the greatest of touches there. A little bit close on the wall, and that's something that's rather unavoidable in butterfly. And Frölander, he was right on the wall and nailed it.
He's been waiting for so long. Lars Frölander of Sweden. The first gold medal at this meeting. Therese Alshammer got a silver. They took the bronze in the freestyle relay. Lars Frölander wins in 52 flat. Klim is second. Huegill is third.
Guys, that was a fantastic swim. You both gave it absolutely everything. You've got a silver medal.
Oh, I don't think it was a fantastic swim. I think we both know that we could have done a lot better. But, we still won medals at the Olympics. Lars did an exceptional race. Best time, and got to give him credit. But I'm sure that Geoff and myself know that we should have grabbed that race, and unfortunately, he got away from us.
You put yourself under a fair bit of pressure. Do you think it's taken its toll?
No, I enjoyed it. I think I got the most out of myself today. That's what the Olympics are all about. So we're here to swim under pressure and trying to perform. And if you can't handle it, don't do it.
Congratulations to you. You've got a bronze medal. How hard was it to relax after last night's semi-final?
I don't know. I got to sleep pretty easy last night. I think it was trying to relax today. That was sort of the main thing. I'm pretty happy with the performance. I mean, I've come into this meet with nothing. I've walked away with the bronze medal. And, it's what you can do on the day. And, full credit to Lars and Michael.
Congratulations. We're very proud of both of you.
Thanks.
Yes, congratulations. In the men's 100 metres butterfly, Australia has never won gold in the 100 butterfly, and again, it has eluded them here in Sydney. But let's take nothing away from Lars Frölander, from Michael Klim, who won the silver, and Geoff Huegill, who qualified fastest the bronze. A great moment, though, for Michael Klim. Medal,
representing Australia, Michael Klim.
And now the bronze medal to the man who qualified fastest, Geoff Huegill.
Médaille de bronze, représentant l'Australie.
Winner of the bronze medal, representing Australia, Geoff Huegill.
Prime Minister Howard and Mrs. Howard in attendance